alone. The trees were alert that night, their trunks craning over the small bundle abandoned on the forest floor. Their black tendrils waved with noiseless certainty. Their roots tunneled through the ground, the echoes of their prey's heart vibrating against the shields. Little animals swirled around their trunks, but only the tiny package in the middle beckoned their attention. A shriek writhed through the air, haunting the tree's senses. They knew that sound, that terrible, pained noise. They too knew the sound of abandonment. Hiss! A snake slithered out between the trees, its slim brown body reflecting the golden night stars. Its dark eyes peered at the tree's prey with interest. It paused beside the bundle, feeling the creature's vibrations through its scales. The snake rose higher on its tummy, its scales rippling under the moonlit sky, the shadows of the trees barely touching the reptile. The snake peered down at the wailing creature, a child, but not the snake's child. The child was scrawny with brown-tinted skin and wispy black tufts of hair. Why was it alone? The snake wondered. It gazed at the trees for an answer, but the trees were silent, lost in memories of love and acceptance. "The prey is ours," the trees murmured after a moment. "We'll take good care of it. We, too, know the pains of loss." The snake hissed, lowering back onto the rough silt. The trees would be no good. They were needy and lonely. They were thinking more of themselves than the child. The snake circled the small creature, guarding it against the nighttime predators. It needed to find someone of the child's own kind, someone brave and selfless enough to take in the infant. But the snake wasn't strong enough to take the child itself. It needed someone else. It peered into the starry night. Blackness swirled in the sky, blotting out the night lights. Yes, the bats could carry the child away. The snake slithered back between the trees, watching as the bats grasped the cradle and swooped into the sky. The young bats fluttered around the crib, the bold ones gripping onto the bed with their talons. Words flitted through the community. Where? The cradle was lifted higher into the sky, the forest becoming a green blanket shivering in the wind. An ocean slept to the right, its churning body reflecting the lights of a town. "There," the leader murmured. Gently, the bats twirled to the ground, landing before a squat green house beside the sea. "Are you sure?" a younger bat hissed, glancing at the dark dwelling. "Is anyone even there?" "I've seen them," the leader hummed. "There are three females who inhabit this place. They already have a young adopted daughter. They will know what to do." With that, the colony of bats twisted into the air, leaving the cradle alone in front of the stoop. "Happy birthday, Amelia!" Eleanor Quintanilla smiled at her daughter. Amelia, the small girl who had been found in front of a house, giggled and clapped her hands. She peered at the rose-colored cake on the kitchen table with wide eyes. "I can't believe she's 8, Eleanor's partner, Tanya Patil, said as she came into the room, clutching a tablet to take photos. "We've had her for 8 years. Eleanor nodded. She crouched beside Amelia and spoke softly in Panamanian Spanish. "You are such a bright girl, Amelia. We love you so much." Amelia smiled and pointed at the cake. Eleanor laughed and glanced at Tanya. "This girl!" Tanya shook her head, though a smile glinted on her lips. "You have to wait, Amelia, dear," she said in Marathi. "Your sister and May are coming soon." In the background, a door creaked open, bringing with it a storm of Vietnamese words. Tanya and Eleanor glanced at one another, neither of them understanding what was being said. "Well, I can hear Maisie and Stella all right," Tanya said with a grin. Eleanor sighed and stood up. "Maisie, Stella, come! The cake is ready!" "We're coming, Mama!" a young woman's voice called. Soon, a slender woman of 19, Amelia's sister, slid into the kitchen, carrying flowers. May saw someone she needed to talk to. Eleanor and Tanya looked at each other, frowning. "Is that person here now, Maisie?" Tanya asked. Maisie nodded. She set the flowers down. At the table, Amelia groaned, peering at the cake with longing eyes. Maisie smiled and knelt beside her sister. "You are so beautiful." Two similar-looking women crept into the room. One, Stella, appeared to be the same age as Tanya and Eleanor. The other, Angelica, seemed a few years younger. Stella smiled and rushed over to Amelia. "Happy birthday, Amelia, my daughter." The younger woman stayed at the rim of the kitchen, watching the scene with apprehensive eyes. Tanya, Eleanor, Stella said. She nodded at the woman she came in with. This is my sister Angelica. I haven't seen her in almost 10 years, but we just happened upon each other today at the store. Angelica blushed as Tanya and Eleanor scrutinized her. She stammered, Stella here has always been nice to me. Stella grinned. You're my sister. Of course I have been. Right. Stella turned to her daughters. Amelia, meet your aunt. Maisie, you already have, but... Stella sighed and brushed back a strand of black hair. Like I was saying to you walking over here, Angelica, Amelia looks just like you did when you were her age. Tanya's gaze shifted between Angelica and Amelia, recognizing the similarities between the two. Yes, there definitely is some resemblance. It's incredible. Well, enough chatting, Eleanor said. Let me get the knife out so we can all start eating. Tanya, Stella, and Maisie chuckled and began rummaging around the kitchen to get utensils and platters. Angelica stared at Amelia, whose attention was stolen by the cake. So, where have you been these last 10 years? Eleanor asked, noticing with discontent Angelica's fascination with Amelia. I don't recall you being at Stella, Tanya, and my wedding. Oh, Angelica doesn't like hanging around people, Stella said, giggling. I don't think you ever mentioned having a sister before, Tanya noted. She placed 6 plates on the table. Well, we had a falling out, you see, Stella said. Her eyes flickered to Angelica. Angelica peered at her feet. Angelica got caught in something bad, something I disapproved of. Anyways, let's have cake and celebrate our little Amelia. Tanya smiled. You're right. Today is for Amelia. Eleanor nodded, but her eyes lingered on Angelica. Amelia's 3 adopted mothers and her sister sat down at the table. Eleanor began cutting up slices of cake. Are you going to sit? Stella asked Angelica, her eyebrows raised. There's no chair, Angelica murmured. Stella stood and pushed over a chair from the living room. You could have just asked, Angelica. Where would you like to sit? Oh, how about between Maisie and Amelia? They are your nieces, after all. Without waiting for a reply, Stella squashed the chair between her daughters. Stella peered at her sister expectantly. Are you going to sit? I got you a chair. Oh, let her be, Stella, Eleanor said. I'm sure Angelica will sit if she wants to. Stella nodded and returned to her seat. Oh, today is such a good day for birthday celebrating, Tanya said. Not too hot, not too cold. Amelia, what do you want to do after we eat? Since Amelia's mouth was filled with cake, the girl did not answer. Maisie giggled. She's such a cutie. She's been dying to eat this cake since she saw it this morning, Eleanor said, shaking her head. I've never seen a girl so obsessed with birthday cake. She's like this every year, Maisie said. She loves her cake. Stella let out a sob. All 4 other people at the table glanced at her. Something the matter, Stella? Tanya asked, her eyes filling with concern. It's Angelica. She's left, and I didn't even notice. Sure enough, the woman at the rim of the kitchen was gone. Angelica, Amelia's biological mother, stood at the edge of her sister's street, peering at the afternoon sun shimmering down on the world. The trees, bats, and snakes stayed huddled in the darkness of the forest, and for now, Angelica and Amelia, mother and daughter, were still both alone.